My first job, I went up in salary by $40,000. And I'm not telling you that to sound like one of these tech bros of, we can make all this money. Okay, that was terrible. I'm sorry, I promise you I'll never do that again. But I'm telling you that because what it really showed me anyways is not that that was realistic for every job that I would go to next. Of course not. The more senior you get, your salary gets leveled out, of course, or your total comp as well. But what it showed me, and for those of you watching, when you're first starting out in your career, oftentimes many of us will end up taking a position that might be underpaying us a little bit. And for me, that was definitely the case. I was so excited to get my first job that I said, I don't care about salary, I just want experience, which I am very grateful for that I did, and there was a lot of pros and cons to that at the time, but the purpose being, depending on where you're at in your career, it will look different from jumping from one salary to the next, one compensation to the next, I should say. And that's really why I wanted to make this video, is because I get so many comments and questions around, I feel underpaid, or I want to switch jobs, but I don't know how. And right now the market is kind of scary. You go on social media, you see the news, and it's saying how all these individuals are getting laid off. And what does this mean? So I thought this video now is more important than ever, really, to really ensure you are well equipped for applying to your next tech job and how to make sure to get that bank.
First, we gotta talk about your resume. Where is that at? Make sure to not only dust it off, but actually put some work into each application you use it for. I know, it sounds like a lot of work.
Give this video a like if you have done this in the past. Gone to write your resume and then just blasted it out to hundreds of jobs. I think everyone watching this should like this video at this point, because I've been there too. I've done this so many times. The problem with that though is a lot of times it's actually not a human that's reviewing your resume to start off with. And if you are using the same resume with not unique keywords associated to what job you are applying to, your resume is going to get lost. Imagine you are applying to a job that hundreds, maybe even sometimes thousands of people are applying to. I know for myself, when I go on LinkedIn, for example, and you can actually see how many other applicants have applied to that job. That to me sometimes is almost a deterrent if there's too many people that apply to this job that I was like, oh, that sounds amazing, but it shouldn't be. What it should do is really fuel you to ensure your resume is going to stand out. Well, how do you make your resume stand out? For one, you need to specifically apply to each job. It's way better to apply to one or two jobs a day than say apply to 10 or 20 jobs. Quality over quantity goes a long way here. And I know you'll often hear that job hunting is a numbers game, which is true, but it's also a quality game. Take time to actually ensure your resume is aligned up to what the job posting is for. This isn't saying change who you are or your skills or abilities, but it might be something simple as in their job posting, they refer to it as software engineering, and on your resume, you have software development. Now, sometimes this won't be a big deal, but other times, depending on the system they use, this might not get inserted through to a real human. Inserted through? Pass a test. Let's go with pass a test. Here are some tools that I really like when I am looking to see if my resume matches up to a job posting. We have this one here, which is great for ensuring your keywords are the same. This one here, which will give you suggestions on to what to add to your resume, what the resume score is, and one more here.
This might sound even more painful than my first tip about updating your resume, which is utilize your network.
When I look for a job, one of the things I really struggle with is reaching out to my network. And I know that sounds funny, it's your network, it's your friends, but it's, I always feel as though I am using them or asking for something I shouldn't be asking. It's a weird feeling for me, and maybe some of you have felt the same way. And I was actually having this conversation the other day with someone, and they said, you know what, Tiff, when you are on the other side of that and someone comes to you for help or for advice or to see if you know anyone that's hiring, does it stress you out or does it give you the, ugh, why are they reaching out? No, it never does. But what does stress me out and what I really do not enjoy is when people beat around the bush. They come to me and they say things like, hey Tiff, I wanna catch up for coffee. I wanna see how you're doing, with a sole intent of asking about a job posting or asking about something. Now that's fine, but being upfront and honest about why you want to connect with someone goes a long way. Time is very valuable, and the busier, the older we get, it seems like more responsibilities keep on coming our way. When you are reaching out to your network and asking them about jobs or different tips for that job hunting process, be upfront as to what you are looking for. You can do that and still be kind. But there's a second part to this. The second part to networking is reaching out to people you might not know. Now, what do I mean by this? Well, for example, if you are starting to apply to jobs, you also need to reach out to the recruiter for that job, reach out to the hiring manager. Take that extra step to really stand out. Another thing that I will sometimes do if I'm looking to reach out to someone very particular and maybe they are someone that might get bombarded with tons of different LinkedIn messages is I actually subscribe to a platform that shares different email addresses with me. The one I have is called Zoom Info and it's definitely not cheap and there are tons of other ones out there. Let's see, let's go through a few right now. Okay, one more. All right. You get the point. There are different ones out there where you can type in someone's name, see where they work, and also their email. This is a great way, well, first of all, don't abuse this system, but if you are having trouble getting in touch with someone that you really feel you are a good position for this role, or maybe they want to explore if they have openings that they aren't posting, using these tools is something that a lot of job seekers do, but we just don't share that information.
Prepare for your interview. This is so key. Don't treat your interview like you have no control over it. You have all the control in it.
Taking time to properly prepare for interviews is something that so many people miss out on. They rather would spend their time worrying about the interview versus actually preparing themselves and hopefully doing really well on it. So what does preparing for an interview really look like? For one thing, if you are preparing for a technical interview, aside from the obvious preparing for the technical aspects of it, ensure to focus as well on the soft skill side. This is something that too often is kind of pushed to the side, especially for technical roles. There are so many great platforms out there nowadays that will really help you be able to practice your interviews. I know one that I've shared recently is Google Warm Up, which is a great way to actually talk to an AI, which kind of feels like a person to get a sense of an interview process. There are also a bunch of other ones. And also, I'm linking all these down below so you can easily access them.
Now, this is really where you will stand out. This is what will make or break your next decision, which is around salary negotiation. I know, the most uncomfortable part for many of us for this process, but why should it be really?
Oh, salary negotiation. This is the critical part of the interview. So you've come a long way, you've put in so much work for this job interview that it feels almost like, I just wanna take anything, I just wanna get through this, I'm so close to the finish line. But the reality is, if you don't take the time to properly negotiate your salary, what will happen is you will start resenting this company. And going back full circle to what I shared with you at the very beginning, this is exactly what happened to me. I started realizing what my coworkers were getting paid, as I'm sure we all have those chats over the coffee, water cooler? Water cooler. This is after being remote for too many years. I don't know what we do in office anymore. But the reality is you start having these conversations with people and realize that you are getting underpaid. And in turn, you can't help but start resenting where you work and starting to look other places. So ensuring you negotiate a salary that is both fair to you and the company that you feel good about is essential for long-term growth with this company. So how do you do that? Well, for one, you need to do your research. I really enjoy levels.fyi. They have some great research that they have done, great data they have on there that you can start specifying by role, location, company. Now it does focus mainly on big tech, but it is starting to focus on some smaller tech companies as well. So definitely check that out for kind of a base range. And ensure when you do, you educate yourself not only on full compensation, but what base salary looks like, what stock looks like, understand what these are and how it will fit into your negotiating strategy. So someone comes to you and says, what are your expectations for total comp? This can be played in so many ways and I've seen so many videos saying to do this, not to do this. And I'll be honest with you, I'm not going to give you a one way or the other for the reason being everyone's comfort zone is so different. And when I see these videos, I think I would never do that. Maybe it worked for them, but it doesn't mean it would work for me. And that's something you need to figure out, but you do need to get comfortable with having those uncomfortable conversations talking about numbers. And if that company doesn't see your value or your worth, that's okay. There are tons of companies out there. It's one of those things that you really need to be aligned on in order to facilitate long-term growth. Also, if you are looking to practice salary negotiation, this website here, interviewer.io, I recently discovered it. It's not free, I'll give you that, but if you're really scared about this or nervous about this negotiation part, I would definitely check it out. It gives you an opportunity to start playing around to practicing negotiating a salary. And it's a great way to get comfortable with just that repetitive process about talking about numbers, about why you are saying these numbers, and so much more.
All right, I hope you enjoyed this video and learned some valuable takeaways to how not only how to apply to jobs, how to really lean into your network, and also to your potential network, what that looks like, and some tips around salary and negotiation. It's something that should not be so taboo and not spoken about. We need to be upfront and honest about what we think our worth is, why we think that, and also sometimes not be afraid to turn down an opportunity, knowing that if your gut is telling you that, it's probably because there's something better on the horizon. All right, if you haven't already, you know the drill. Hit that subscribe button, give this video a like, and leave in the comments other videos I should create. And I'll do my best to respond to every single one of your comments. All right, no more coffee for me. I've had enough coffee.